Welcome to the Smoke Learning Channel. From watching the other videos regarding Autodesk Smoke, you have learnt that the Action Compositor works in a 3D environment. Now you can move layers and cameras in 3D space. But in a real 3D environment, you have even more 3D functionality that you may or may not have discovered. This video will highlight the starting workflow for applying 3D displacement to an action surface. On various levels, you can make waving flags, animated organic textures, and much more. If you would like to follow along, please click the link in the YouTube description to download the media. If you're watching the podcast version of this video, then type the link displayed in your internet browser. Now let's get started. We are in a 1080p HD project using a 23.976 frame rate. I have already created a 4-second black color source, and this is edited into a sequence as the basis for the effect. I'll select the segment and add a connect effects. All the work we will be doing is inside the Action 3D Compositor. So hover over the node bin and press A for action. Drag the node and drop it into the connection. Now when it comes to doing any displacement, you need two components. The source you are going to displace and the displacement map to perform the distortion. In the media panel, drag the flag and its displacement map into the Connect Effects schematic. To use these clips in action, select the Action node and press Ctrl-N twice to add two media inputs. Connect the flag into the first media input, and connect the displacement clip into the second media input. Don't connect any blue inputs, as we are not using alpha channels this time round. Double-click on the Action node to bring up its controls, and press Escape to see the Action schematic. Now looking at the result on the right and the schematic on the left, you can see that by default, any sources coming into Action are added as 3D surfaces. We want to keep the flag and its transformation axis, but we don't need the displacement map as a 3D surface. So just select those nodes and delete them. The displacement clip must be applied as a displacement map to the flag 3D surface. Select the flag object as the recipient of the displacement map. Switch to the Action bin. Select Media Entry 2, which is the displacement map. In the Action node bin, switch to the Maps tab just to highlight the mapping tools. Double-click on the Displace Map object. You will see in the Action schematic that the second clip has been added as a displacement map with its own axis transformation node. Also note that it is parented to the flag image object. This tells you that the displacement will affect the flag image. To see the displacement correctly, you require lighting to see the shading. So switch to the Node Preferences, Rendering tab, and enable Shading. The global lighting environment is enabled. Double-click on the displacement node to bring up its controls. Push the displacement away from the surface by setting the Z slider to 100. Z displaces the surface forward or backward. If Smoke does not react when you adjust this, just ensure that the regen button is turned on. Now the displacement is really harsh, so increase the softness to 20. So the brightness of the displacement map, which is Luma Y, is distorting the flag. Press Option O to orbit the camera and drag around the viewer to see the effect of the displacement. Let's work with it at this angle for a bit. Switch back to Move Mode using the Tools menu. Double-click on the flag image object. Set the surface shine to a value of 10. This will give the image a more reflective feel. If the shininess is too much, click on the specular color pot. Change the mode to HLS. The specularity is currently white. Let's halve that by dropping the luminance to 0.5. Click OK to confirm. Scrub the time bar to see the results we have so far. Now, if I had planned this displacement map perfectly, we wouldn't have to tweak it. But this is never the case. We will now fine-tune the displacement map. It is worth noting at this point that the image and the displacement map do not need to be the same resolution. We just use an axis to manipulate it to what we want. Select the axis node for the displacement map. Scale it up to around 300%. Now rotate the displacement to a 45-degree angle. Scrubbing the time bar, you can see how the result looks much better. So that's a waving flag if you ever need one. But let's rejig this as an animated texture. Switch to the default camera tab and reset the camera. Double-click on the main image axis to move the entire 3D surface. Scale the surface up to 150%. Now let's move the flag to the left at minus 300. Next, let's tilt the flag for a better angle. Push the flag over by setting X to minus 30. Set Y to 20. And finally, Z to 25. So that's looking pretty good, but I want to use lighting to enhance it more. Switch to the Action Node bin. Choose the Relighting tab and drag a light into the action schematic. The light result should be seen instantly. Now I would like to have this light to have the same positioning as the flag. So drag a connection from the flag's axis node to the light. The light snaps into position, but obviously it still does not look correct. We need to reposition the light relative to the surface. Double-click the light and move it back in Z to 800. Now drop its spread all the way down to 30. Tilt the light in Y to minus 10. So now that it is slightly off from the flag, adjust the light's X position to minus 125. Scrubbing the time bar, you can see how we have progressed from a 3D displaced flag to a textured background. Exit Connect Effects and render the segment. Bear in mind that this can be any image and any displacement you choose, so the options are almost limitless. If you liked this video and want more on this topic, please let me know. All feedback is welcome and appreciated. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Smoke Learning channel for future videos.